Hi, this is Yogesh Jadhav from the IT department of Saraswati College of Engineering. Today we are going to discuss about the Java technology and the .NET technology over here. So first of all, we are going to cover the Java technology. Before that one, we are going to put focus on the client-server architecture. So what are the client technologies present and what are the different server technologies present? So when you are going to consider the two-tier architecture, that means there will be one client and there will be server. So let's consider I want to develop the web application in the two-tier architecture. What are the client technologies? How you are going to design the front end over there? So what are the different technologies present for the same? So you are going to develop the front end in the HTML. You are going to do the style sheet by using cascading style sheet. Then there will be a JavaScript. So basically, you are going to use the JavaScript for the form validation. And if you want to integrate the services from the various service providers, Google services, Facebook services, then you are going to use the JavaScript as a mashup technology over there. So you are going to integrate the various application programming interfaces by using JavaScripting. After that one, there will be a jQuery. So if you want to put animations in the web page, you are going to use the jQuery. So basically, you are going to use the jQuery to introduce the animation in the web page. So these are the called as a client-side technology. Now we are going to put focus on the server technologies. If you are going to use the Java platform for the server development, so what are the options you are having? So first one is called as a JSP, that is a Java Server Pages. So when you are going to send a request to the server from the client side, the JSP page will going to give you the reply. So when you are going to use the two-tier architecture in the Java technology, the server side will be handled by the JSP and servlet. Okay, so the question arises in the mind, what are the different services we have available when you are going to use the Java technology? So the most famous one is a Tomcat. So Tomcat is a web server which is the most commonly used in the Java technology. The another is a WebSphere, WebLogic. So these are the various options we are having if you are going to go for the Java platform. So here we are going to see the two-tier architecture. This is a client side, server side. If you are going to implement the server side by using Java platform, then there will be option you are having Java Server Pages with the servlet. Now we are going to consider the three-tier architecture over here. So I will going to keep the client side, server side over here, and I will going to add one more layer to this one, that is called as an application layer. So what are the various options you are going to have when you are going to implement the application layer? So there will be a client, there will be server, that is a web server over here, and this is called as an application server. So why there is a need of application server? You are going to separate out the logic from your web services. So you are going to separate out your web services and logic. So you are going to put the business logic in the application layer. So what are the various technologies if you are going to have over in the application server? The most common is EJB, that is called as Enterprise Java Bean. There are various types in the AGB, that is called as a session bean and message bean. Okay, let's consider, you might be asked the question, where is the database present over here? So database comes after the application server. So this is a database server. So you might be use the MySQL, Oracle, whatever it is there. So how you are going to communicate between the application server and database server, that connectivity is called as a JDBC connectivity. That is a Java database connectivity. So the EJB, that is a entity bin, will going to look after the database connectivity over here. So this is the overall framework and Java platform we've seen. This is the client side, there will be the web server, and there will be the application server. So as we know, we discuss about the what are the web servers present, that is a Tomcat, WebLogic, WebSphere. So now we are going to see what are the application servers are there. So most famous one is called as a GlassFish server over here. So GlassFish server is a application server. So this is a Java technology we've seen over here. After that one, we are going to see the .NET technology. So when you are going to use the .NET platform for the application development, what are the options we are having, that first we are going to cover. So you might be create the console applications, that is the console applications, by using C# programming. Then you are going to create the standalone applications that will be the run on the single machine by using Visual Basic. Then you might be create the web applications by using ASP.NET. Then you might be create the applications that is called as a web forms. So when you are going to use the .NET technology, if you want to create the console application, you have the option C#. If you want to create the standalone application, you go with the VB. If you are going to develop the web application, then you have two choices over here. One is ASP.NET, another is a web form over here. So we are going to put focus on the ASP.NET technology over here. So what is ASP? So ASP is called as Active Server Pages. So this is a server side technology. So when you are going to go with the ASP.NET, again there will be three categories. First one is called as ASP Web Pages. Then there will be ASP MVC architecture, that is a Model View Controller architecture. And the last one is ASP Web Forms. So when you are going to go with the Active Server Pages, ASP.NET technology, there are three options you are having: ASP Web Pages, ASP MVC architecture, and ASP Web Forms. So now we are going to discuss about the how this architecture look like. So previously we discussed about the client-side technologies. In the Java platform, same technologies are present in the .NET platform. So we are going to differentiate that technologies in the server side. So let's consider this is a web server for the .NET technology. So in the web server, which technology you are going to use, that is called as ASP. So that is called as Active Server Pages over here. In the JSP, that is in the Java technology, we use the JSP over there, that is a Java Server Pages. So here that responsibility is taken by the ASP pages. If there will be a three-tier architecture, then there will be a COM, that is a component object model. So alternative in the Java technology for the same is called as a EJB, Enterprise Java Bean. So this is called as an application server. So here the client side technologies both are same in the .NET framework also and Java framework also. Web server, there is a Active Server Pages instead of JSP in the .NET technology, and the server name is called as IIS server. The full form of that one is Internet Information Server. And there will be a database, that is a Microsoft SQL server, and the connectivity is handled by the ADO.NET. So that is Active Data Object.NET. So we are going to now compare the Java technology and .NET technology. the client side programming will be common. At the server side in the Java platform, you are going to use the JSPN servlet, and where in the .NET technology, the alternative for the same is ASP. Then there will be a COM, that is a COM, that is called as application server implementation, and there will be the backend, there will be the Microsoft SQL server, and the connectivity between application server and the database server is handled by the ADO.NET over here. So now we are going to discuss the ASP, web pages. So the latest technology in the ASP web pages is called as a Razor technology. So what in mean by the Razor technology? Let's consider one example. This is the HTML code I am mentioning over here. So this is a simple HTML code. In between this code, if I am to put the C# code, so we are going to put it by using @datetime. So this is a one variable which is a present in the C# which will be used to display the date time in the HTML page. So I integrated the C# code over here in the HTML page, then it's called as a Razor technology. So this is the latest technology present in the ASP.NET, that you are going to directly integrate the C# code in the HTML page with the tag @. So this is the Razor, which is the latest one in the ASP web pages. So after this one, the next one is ASP MVC architecture. So M means it is a model, V means view, and the controller. So now we are going to take an example of a real life example over here to identify or to understand the MVC over here. Let's consider there will be one database which is maintaining the student data. So here this database will be called as a model over here. So if I want to access the student database and I want to get the result on my front end, then there will be suppose HTML pages or web pages are required. So this is called as a view over here. And the communication between the model and the view is handled by your controller. So this is a MVC architecture, that is a model, view, controller in the .NET technology. So it's called as ASP MVC architecture. If you are going to go for the Java technology, alternative for the same is called as a Strut. The Strut technology is using MVC architecture. So this is MVC architecture over here. So let's consider I want to develop the applications by using Java technology, which multiple tools I can use. So you can use the IDE. So what is mean by IDE? That is called as integrated development environment. So these are the tools and applications present by using that applications. You can easily develop the Java applications or .NET applications. So what are the various tools present or IDEs present when you are going to do the Java development? So the most famous is called as a Java NetBeans, which is developed by the Oracle. The next one is called as Eclipse. This is a community software and it is open source, so you can use it. If you want to develop the Android applications, then you can integrate the ADK with the Eclipse over here. So these are the called as IDEs which are present in the Java technology. Now if I want to develop applications for the .NET, so there is a most famous IDE that is called as a Visual Studio. which is provided by the Microsoft itself. So it is a Microsoft application. So by using Visual Studio, you can create the .NET applications. So let's a question arises that one ki Visual Studio, but if I am using the Linux operating system and I want to develop the .NET application, Visual Studio is not supported on the Linux operating system, what alternatives I am having? So there is an alternative that you can use the Mono developer. So Mono developer is a tool, or you can say package, which you can deploy on your Linux operating system, and you can create the .NET applications by using that one. So now we are going to differentiate between the Java technology and .NET technology. So I will going to draw that diagram once again. So if you are going to use the client side technology, the Java and .NET both are same technologies they are using for the front end development. So above one is called as a Java technology, below one is a .NET. So client side, there is a HTML5, CSS3, cascading style sheet, JavaScript, jQuery. Here also the same technologies you are going to use. So this is a client side programming. Now we are going to move to the server. So we are going to consider the three tier architecture for the .NET development and Java development. So we are going to consider as a web server. So at the web server in the Java technology, we are having the option JSP, that is called as a Java server pages. So let's consider at the client side, I created one form and I want to perform the addition and I want to get the result at the client side. So whatever the form you have created, when you are going to click on the submit button, that action is happen at the web server, that JSP pages will going to perform the calculation for you and sending result back at the client side. So the whatever the calculation and computation is handled by the JSP pages over there, and there will be a servlet. So these two technologies we are going to use at the web server. The most famous web servers in the Java is a Tomcat. The another alternatives you are having the WebSphere and WebLogic. So these are the web server names which are present in the Java technology. Then there will be called as an application server. So what are the application server and what you are going to use it? We are going to separate out the web and the business logic. So for the security purpose and the load balancing purpose, we are going to separate out the web server and the logic, that is a business logic. So here you are going to do the implementation of your business logic, and the you are going to use the EJB technology for the same. So that is Enterprise Java Beans. So EJB, most of the common you are going to use to communicate with your backend, that is called as a database. So whatever the database you are going to use, in between that application server and database server, you are going to use the JDBC connectivity for the communication purpose. So the communication between the application server and database server will be handled by the JDBC. Now you are going to, the application server name over here is the most famous one, is a Glassfish server. So the Glassfish server is an application server which is present in the Java technology. Now you are going to do the same with the .NET. What are the different technologies, alternatives you are having when you are going to compare it with the Java? So the front end will be the same. Now you are going to move to the web server. So instead of JSP, you are going to use the ASP and ASP Razor. So that you are going to use the active server pages over here, that is alternative to the JSP and ASP. Again, there are three types over there: ASP web pages, ASP MVC, and ASP web form. And the most famous server for the .NET is called as IIS, that is Internet Information Server over here. So this is a web server. Now you are going to move to the application server. So application server, you are going to use a component object model, which is alternative to the EJB in the .NET. So component object model will going to communicate with the database by using ADO.NET, Active Data Object, .NET technology they are going to use to communicate with the backend, that is a database server. So this overall scenario, that is a Java technology and .NET technology in front of you. So this is the client side, server side communication, three-tier architectures, what are the different servers are present there in the .NET also and in the Java also. This is in front of you. Thank you very much.